elevates the slab substantially. It starts out 2 meters long, and after a few minutes of rolling, it's been stretched to well over 100 meters. Yeah. Pizza cutter style blades trim the edges of the aluminum sheet. Another roller winds the aluminum into a big coil. Then they unwind it and squeeze the aluminum to flatten it. Machinery now pulls the long aluminum sheet forward to a 120-ton punch press. This powerful press forces the metal around the frying pan-shaped die and then punches out the shape. The freshly formed aluminum frying pan falls onto a conveyor below. The leftover aluminum will be used to make new frying pans. The pans now ride a conveyor through a washing station, where they're cleaned and then treated with sodium hydroxide. This opens the pores of the metal to allow an enamel coating to stick to the outside and the non-stick finish to adhere to the inside. A worker inspects the pans and places them upside down on spray fixtures. It's a tight fit to shield the inside from the enamel spray that comes next. The pans spin on the fixtures and twirl by the spray nozzles for an even application of enamel to the exterior of the pans. A glossy clear coat follows. The frying pans transfer to a dryer conveyor. The hot air pulls out water from the enamel coating, and the color goes down from gray to chalky white.
Down.
An automated squeegee silk screens the company name and other information onto the pan bottoms. They now enter a long curing oven heated to 560 degrees Celsius. The cure toughens the enamel.